Good evening.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Speaking of listening or showing and asking what you want, next piece of our program is going to be the soundtrack from Barbie. About the next piece we with myself and Megan on the violin, and I had sent her the sheet music for this a few months ago with my original ideas on how we should perform it. So fast forward to a month after that, Megan and I were finally able to sit down and rehearse this together. And after the first playthrough, I could tell something was off. It wasn't Meg's playing, she's incredible. It's something else, and I went silent and stared into space. Much like I do at weekend mass. After a little while, Meg soon said, "You're quiet and haven't opened your mouth in 3 minutes, so something must be wrong." To which I asked, "Why are we doing a song? Why did I send this to you? What are we doing? I don't understand. I have no introduction to tell the audience. And I was panicking because I'm a planner." She then said something along the lines of, "I think it has to do with Bruce Springsteen," and then I remembered. A few months before giving her the song, I saw Bruce Springsteen at the TD Garden up in Boston, and I heard this next song playing in the overhead before he came out to perform. And I pulled out my iPhone, and I put on that SoundCloud app that tells you what you're listening to. And I wrote in my notes, "We're going to do this at the movie show. Meg's gonna play it." And then for the rest of the night, I had this melody going through my head. Even with Springsteen screaming at me, I didn't let it go. So there's your song introduction. So this is from an old spaghetti western movie in 1968 called Once Upon a Time in the West, starring Charles Bronson.
Thank you. lovely thing. So in movies, it's usually a central genre, right? We have drama, comedy, action, thriller. And within those drama genres are specific themes. And one of the strongest themes is a word that can hold so many meanings, definitions, and feelings. And that word is love. And there are many different types of love. The love of family, the love of pets, the love of old friends and new friends, art, nature, and so on. So how exactly does one define what the word love is? Every single person in this church tonight will answer that differently. Well, about 25 years ago, the famous rock musician Peter Gabriel and his friend Stephen Merritt decided to sit down one day and collaborate with the idea of writing about what they discovered if someone handed them a book of love. What would they find? The definitions, the questions, the answers, the roadblock, the wonder. So this is what they came up with. It's called The Book of Love, which can be heard in the 2004 rom-com, Shall We Dance, starring Richard Gere. And this features, once again, Sam Cournoyer on the verse.
Thank you.
slowly compared to the time experienced on Earth. A single hour on Venus planet would equate to 7 years back on Earth because of the planet's proximity to a black hole. And this is actually a scientific fact. So each click you hear, or each note that a pilot plays, is equal to 1 day. As I said before, Interstellar might be the best sci-fi movie ever, but the core concept of the movie is love. In one of the last scenes of the movie, Murph, who now is considerably older than her father, reunites with him on her deathbed. Murph says, "Nobody believed me, but I knew you would come back." Her father asks, "How?" And her answer was, "Because my dad promised me." What a call of life. Interstellar is not about saving the world, or being the hero, or the best pilot. But it's actually about the father who kept his promise and came back for his daughter.
Thank you.
Greece, Tarzan, Pocahontas, Hercules, and of course the Lion King. So the Lion King has gone on to become the highest grossing traditionally animated film of all time, currently sitting at around $1.8 billion. The songs in this movie are written by the great Elton John, or Sir Elton John, I should say. The score was written by Hans Zimmer, and together, this music from the film went on to win 2 Academy Awards, 2 Golden Globes, and 3 Grammy Awards. And while this movie was part of the Disney Renaissance, it also helped Elton John launch his own mid-career renaissance and return. It was a big year for him, and his next 2 solo albums will go on to win multiple Grammy Awards. So tonight, Sam and I are going to play for you probably the most well-known song from the movie called The Circle of Life. And in an interview with Sir Elton John, he was asked about the process of writing this song, and he said that he's handed the lyrics to it by Bernie Taupin at 2 p.m. that afternoon, so 2 p.m., and by 3:15 p.m., it was done and sent on to Disney. Incredible talent. It took us longer than an hour and 15 minutes to learn it.
Thank you.
2003 classic called Love Actually. True. There's a trail near my house in Yarmouth Court that I walk on just about every day after my morning coffee, and it's that part of the day that gives me the space to think and get my head together. And it also allows me to ponder life's most difficult thoughts, like, why does an inchworm actually measure 2 inches? Or why is it impossible to throw out a garbage can? Anyway, one morning on my walk, I went on Spotify on my phone and I searched famous movie piano instrumentals to hopefully find an idea for tonight's performance. And of the first 10 results, 3 of them were from the greatest movie of all time, Love Actually. The music from the movie was written by Craig Armstrong, and his style of writing was very, very simplistic. Simple melodies and chords intertwining between the dialogue of the movie. And the reason I love Craig Armstrong's music so much is because of the simplicity and how he's able to paint an atmosphere with just a few notes. So for tonight, I thought I'd take 3 of the main themes of the movie and connect them. And I call it 3 melodies connected from the movie song.
And flows away from your head, and ice cream.
next piece is a very unique situation of a song. In 2021, Netflix released the movie Arcane: League of Legends, which is an action adventure story revolving around two sisters named V and Jinx living in a postmodern fictional universe. And this story is again another soliloquy like earlier in the evening. We don't quite know if the narrator is struggling in a romantic relationship or a friendship. We'll hear how this narrator is dealing with its feelings, the struggles of hurt, of heartache, revenge, acceptance, and inevitably moving on. And the aspect that captured my attention the most of this soliloquy is that the narrator is a robot. It's not a human. In the movie, the characters are half human, half machines. And we hear from the point of view of this AI robot that is so technologically advanced that it has feelings. So why did I choose this song for the concert? Well, those of you here who follow our concerts, and I know a lot of you do, and we love you so much. You know that I love Sting. Sting has a way of placing himself into situations that he's unfamiliar with and creating an atmosphere that constantly blows me away. So remember now that I said the narrator is a machine or a robot. Well, pay close attention to the lyrics. Sting was very creative in his word usage. For example, in the narrator's cry of anger, it says, "I want you to hurt like you hurt me to dent." And I instantly think of a robot dented or destroyed, physically, or in this case, emotionally. That's right. And I dedicate this to my mother, not because I want her to hurt, she's the most beautiful woman in the world, but she made one request and said, when you do the movie show this year, can you do this song? And I said, of course. So this features Sam on voice and features a beautiful violin solo by Dan. And this is called What Could Have Been by Sting. as a musician to be here at Alpine here playing just for you tonight. I'm going to be going to love the newest member of our little group, and I think you'll be seeing a lot more of him. Please welcome Ryan Shannon. Thanks again for coming, everyone. It really does mean a lot to us. We're going to leave you with this last piece. Get home safe.